Hey guys, Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Westerlo career mode. Where last time I left off, I picked up two more wins in the league. Common currents, pretty much by now. Oh, you know the deal. Well, in this episode, I have a game. Here it's Antela. Hector, you're probably saying to yourself, oh, if you haven't seen the past couple episodes, didn't he play Anderlecht a few episodes ago? I did, but that was in the league. This is the quarterfinal of the cup. Of course, you would know that if you've been watching the series up until now. And if you did know that, then this might be your first episode. Which might mean you're a bit confused as well. What's going on?
Well, the quarterfinal coming up, home and away.
I would recommend you go back and watch the rest of the series.
Which team is the stronger? And they are
just so you're up to date and in this leg, knowing what is going on.
And we can see here how Anderlecht are going to line up. I think that back four is really important. And he's in there with a header. He's just put it off target, just wide of that post.
Well, his teammates were convinced he was going to score there, I think.
Obradovic moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. He's got to play it back to the goalkeeper. It's a terrible place to give the ball away. Well, this is certainly going to be...
Oh. Now that the free kick has been given. Yellow card. Nothing I can... I can't really... I can't complain away. About that. That's a...
Maybe it could be difficult for the player.
Fair yellow card.
The ref as well.
From...
That's a pretty comfortable save.
From my player.
It was on target.
I can say that the free kick from Anderlecht was, not... up to scratch and very disappointing. Yeah, I was expecting better from the team. Many say are the best team in the Belgian league. I mean,
and here comes the counter.
They're second in the table. Well, to me,
has to go and get the ball for the goal
at the moment.
He's the one we're focusing on. I think with good reason.
Not bad at all. Four goals in his last three games. Another danger man to keep an eye out for.
Diego Capel. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. It's good play until they got that challenge in.
Keep the ball in. Check. And I cleared it, which is another big check. On the old list. Now, if I can manage to work my way into a goal-scoring position.
This is how they love to play on the break.
Nico, Olic.
Shot's taken. Goal. They're in front.
This is his competition, so far. He was the star of the show in the first cup game against Standard Liège. He's scoring four goals, and now he's got another goal.
Played, isn't it? This kind of breakaway, and they couldn't live with him.
Well, if you got pace, as this side have, you're always going to be a threat on the counter. It's a wonderful finish.
Five goals now in the...
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
I still don't know how to pronounce this because these videos haven't gone live.
Appiah.
It was only in the video you will see on Sunday. That I had the first game against Stanley in this competition. When I asked how the cups name is properly pronounced. I am calling it croaky, as if it's like a goddamn frog tournament of some description. Or
onto the attack now.
Maybe it's trying big a cup for okay, or perhaps cricket. I do want to know how to pronounce it properly. And I did ask indeed in the last episode. I don't know, I'll ask again if anyone does know how to pronounce it correctly. Or maybe I am pronouncing it correctly. If I am pronouncing it incorrectly, then tweet me how to pronounce it correctly. To my Twitter account. Here appears four.
For the shot. Oh, well saved. Corner to come now. Looking a bit listless in
It would be much appreciated.
Okay. He looks as though he's not as healthy as normal, that's for sure.
Well, you see there by the graphic how few times
it'll help
he's touched the ball.
Better this.
Think about tweaking the system.
Career mode. Would end the series in turn. If I know how to pronounce the cup I am competing in. I always just called the Belgian cup.
They cope with it well defensively. High class quarterfinal we're watching here, no question about that. And just
half time, 1-0 only. Here you can see the two of the other quarterfinal matches. Club Brugge look like they're going out. Ooh, because that match is in the 75th minute for some reason. Must have started early. And Genk are losing at halftime, 1-0.
Well, there's still time to hit back in this game, and they're going to try and do it with a substitute.
Treble coming on there for Anderlecht.
Here we go, the referee's blown his whistle, and we're off for the second half. A timely challenge.
Romans.
Appiah.
Romans.
Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch.
Nikolic.
Shot up.
Oh, and the defender gets enough on it to send it out wide for the corner kick. Romans! Off the line! Send it back into the box.
Going to be a substitution here for the
Roman, someone on the edge.
Presented possession to the opposition now.
That didn't go as planned.
Diego Capel. And the referee's letting it go.
Yeah, he can get a yellow card. Wait, he's not getting a yellow card?
Like that with a slide tackle of getting into serious trouble.
Yeah, I think so. And it was a
I would think that's a yellow card. Apparently I'm wrong in that. And I'm alone in that.
That's goes for goal with the head.
What I should say is, well, like I'm wrong in my opinion that that was a yellow card offense. For Tribble.
One or two players are warming up for the home
Oxford.
Team. We'll see who comes on.
Welcome to Nico. Lick. Can he score again? I over the bar.
Excited there. We all thought he was going to score.
And here comes the counter-attack. He's got a shot off now.
Not sure why they waited so long to bring on Tielemans.
20 minutes now remaining.
Tough for a throw. With about 15 minutes plus stoppage time left in this match.
It's a quick break.
Nikolić could be clean through. 2-0. Yes. And he scored again. Oh, all 6 goals I've scored in this competition have all come from the same player.
2 for him on the day.
And that second goal might sink Anderlecht.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
This is similar to what happened against Standard Liège, actually. There was a goal then for a really long period. I couldn't break Standard Liège down for that second goal, but once I got the second goal, the third and fourth reined in and pretty quickly. He fall.
Hey. Successful
touch. Sure, the same thing won't happen again.
9 remaining minutes. The break is definitely on.
Or will it? Nikolić has completed another hat trick. No freaking way that's gonna happen again. No freaking way that would happen again.
Well, Alan, maybe that's the one he'll treasure the most because it's given him the hat-trick.
Yeah, and he'll be taking home that match ball with a great deal of pride.
That's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets underway.
This is already... He nailed on to be the year he dominates this competition.
Got the tackle in. Well, this is a real shock. Can see it in the faces of the players.
I mean, he could be set to break some
from these supporters.
Hurt.
Well, those fans can't even be bothered to give their players any stick at the moment. They're just stunned into silence.
Trying to thread it through here. Tackled well.
7 goals and 2 Oogie. This is not exactly something you see every year. It might be 8. Oh! Mass! Oh! He can't. Oh, you're freaking kidding me! He wins! And the referee ends the game. And there is no fourth goal this time, and so it's only 3. But.
But it's a great start. The first leg of this quarter final, and they have now got a lead for the second leg.
Yeah, it's gone perfectly for them. They've done their job.
It's a second match, but. Oh, with 2 8 goals, adding on to an earlier one from Marco Nikolić. That's a very odd coincidence. Oh, Genk equalized against Mechelen. So. Do they go to to extra time? Do they go to penalties? What happens with them? I mean, I feel like it's not giving me any kind of information here. It's not saying anything about them going to extra time or penalties. Is there there's a second leg. That's why it didn't go to extra time or penalties. There's a second leg. Well, 3-0 up. I didn't know there was a second leg. Like, Interesting. Very, very interesting. After this game, I will be 2/3 of the way through the season. As we go up against Loughran.
They have had some tremendous performances at home. In fact, Alan, it's the best home record in the league.
So hard to take points off this team.
Home game number 10.
Wins in 9 home games. No complaints from the fans here.
Alan, what do you make of the home side here today?
When you're on the top of the table, Martin, you're there to be shot at. And as potential champions, that's what you have to handle. I wonder if they can today.
Now you've got your chance to check on the lineup for the home team. I think that back four is really important for them. They've got to be strong and solid, but they've got a bit of protection, haven't they?
They have. They should have more than enough. I mean, they're all good defenders in their own rights, but... In front of them, they've got players who are going to be working really hard. Whether they could be a threat on the front foot, we'll wait and see.
Tackle here. Attacking well here.
Helpful.
Wants to get at him, and he's missed with a chance to get... Well, he's put it
away. Oh, great start. Hurt from help.
It's come to him so early in the game, but I have to say, he reacted perfectly. Really sharp right from the off, and they've taken the lead here.
Aim well to go.
Well, it's going to be that change. It always
hell?
And the injured player departs, and the substitute will be.
It's a really early substitution from.
And that.
Loughran is an injury? What happened there? It just randomly made a substitution after I scored. Oh, it was an injury. What happened? Did you guys see that? I didn't notice anyone go down with an injury.
Up into a good position here, and then just lost the.
But apparently,
lost the ball as well.
Petosi.
Work hard to try and get it back.
Petosi, he for Loughran, is an early casualty.
Coming up. For those who talk about a winter break, it's not.
I thought they were making a substitution in response to my goal. I was like. We'll be thinking, what is he doing?
The way you might want to be sitting at home rather than sitting in the stadium.
Yeah, I think it's worse for.
And it's a heading chance now. Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected it. Excellent control in a tight area. Trying to switch on the attacking power. Wonderful chance. They scored.
Great goal for Alpo. We had 2 hat tricks in the last episode. We're both coming from Gamvola. Are we going to get another hat trick? Double hat trick in consecutive matches in the same episode? Wouldn't this episode?
Restarting at 2-0.
Strindberg is again on a brace. This is one way to remind people that there is still
patience is the name of the game.
Someone else trying to
could be dangerous.
Get to the top goal scorer and
could be a yellow card
in Gamvola. The amount of goals that
good challenge
Gamvola has scored recently Strömberg is going to have to make
the defender
up that and hope that Genvola doesn't add to his total in that time period.
Maybe that will ease the pressure.
I think that second goal was his 24th.
How well saved!
Because I think it said his.
Out the pass.
Yeah, it was 24 because the first one was his 23rd. So that would put him seven goals behind Genvola.
And this is going to be a throw.
10 games remaining after this, so plenty of time. And the possibility of the
attack going.
Playoffs as well.
Hit the post.
Oh.
Well, that'll be a throw. And here's the cross. And in comes the header. And it's in. Perfect header. And a special goal.
We're coming in from the
one problem for
wonderful delivery.
Strömberg is Genvola is not going to stay quiet.
It was some header.
Willingly. Sorry, I just had to suppress the yawn there.
3-0. Just, game gets underway.
Getting late. Heat, but I can power through. This is my last video that I have to record.
Well, and intercepted.
For the week. Head.
On the attack here. We could be in. And shoots! It's a goal!
That. Genvola, as if the response to Strömberg's two goals has gotten a quick fart though of his own. And now both strikers are on a hat trick. It's looking good. If Genvola scores a hat trick, it would be three hat tricks in a row in consecutive league games.
Onto the attack now.
And who not only wants to be top goal scorer, but seems hell bent on trying his damnedest to
tackle goes in.
Become the all-time top goal scorer in the Pro League.
I guess the coach might have said, well, if they can do that in one half, you can do it in the other half. But it's going to take a lot of character for the losing side to...
Opportunity now! Up for grabs here.
It's gone out for a throw. That's a wasted throw. He's given it straight to the opposition.
Into the attacking third.
Genvola! Great save.
Full stretch. Corner coming up. And here's the shot.
Oh, Henry gets it. In on the goal scoring fun himself. Making it 5-0.
The goalkeeper did get a touch.
Not score
to keep the ball out of his
loads of goals since joining in the summer transfer window, but he's played his part.
If you're losing count, it's
5-0. I him to be a goal scorer.
Ferreira. 1-2, and having a little game of their own here. Doing well to keep the ball. And in goes the cross.
I'm happy for him to...
Well, the guy who's up 90 minutes, half an hour to go.
Goals, but then again, he seemed to play a lot through middle, so I don't even know if he has that many assists.
Possibly the snow actually helped him with that challenge. Well, that is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. Here comes the challenge. And that ball belongs to the goalkeeper. Here's a chance to attack, and he could get away here.
Oh, Genvola! I thought about the first time. It would give me the edge!
Frame of the goal.
Oh, how did nothing come from that? That little goal mouth scramble.
Tight against the touch line, and pretty clear he's going to end up with a throw.
Can't.
Well, he tried to find the ball. His man, but he's only put the ball into touch.
They gave me back the ball, and I gave it back to them. Brilliant.
Strong, fair challenge. Pulls out for a throw, though. Trying to get it wide, and it was a good idea, but he couldn't find his supporting player. Excellent performance from the team. The supporters know that the job is pretty much done, and they're just loving it. I don't think we'll get them out of the ground at the end.
Well, they've been treated to some really good football, haven't they? Some good goals, and they've appreciated it.
And it's a headed effort at goal.
Tackle just got me thinking. Who would I give the penalty to in this situation if I were to get one?
It has been a case of the die being cast pretty early.
I guess logic would dictate that I would give it to whoever has the higher penalties. I think Genvola takes the penalties anyway. He doesn't? I've only gotten one penalty throughout this whole career mode. Maybe two. So,
out of play for
a fully aware who the penalty taker is, because I've not been a gang. Them
attacking well here. Went in well.
I mean, I know. Well, you shouldn't be expecting to get penalties.
Just spotted the ball up and then playing. And that will be a throw.
I got a surprising lack of them.
And that will be another throw here. Looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down. Oh, the board's gone up. Four added minutes. Into the attacking third.
Genvola. Try to get the ball across. Henry will get back in there. Oh, I thought it was falling perfectly for Alpo. Oh, Nierman is going to get a hat trick. There is the full time whistle. Genk beat Anderlecht. So, two defeats in a row for Anderlecht. Not a good day for them. That's for sure. Finish off on some training as Mias goes up to 61. I think I called him Mass earlier, which is my mistake. That E kind of looked like an S, just to a fatigued brain. Risk of losing four players. They are clearly not worth a goddamn thing if I haven't signed them up to a contract already. One more game between this and the window opening, but that will be in the next episode. Until then, and this is the end of this episode. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new, and until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.